Hey, let's see. Okay, having a little technical difficulties tonight, you guys, but we are rocking and rolling. And so normally for team calls, I tend to type out a bunch of notes and really have an idea of the guideline of where this is going to go. And tonight I really don't, because there has been a lot of things going on. Hi, Annette. There's been a lot of things going on where we might be having things that are stealing our joy, or we might be having things that we find ourselves comparing. And I had a really big smack in the face, self-development mindset shift that I didn't really know exactly where I was exactly, because I feel like I'm coming up on my 5 years, and I feel like maybe this can happen to anybody in any place in their journey. But for me, it's very real and it's very raw and it's very vulnerable. And it's definitely something that I wanted to bring to you guys, because you might be feeling the same way as well. Or you might be finding yourselves down the path of feeling this way as well. I feel like it's so super important when you're starting this entire journey, whether you're starting it for the products or whether you're starting it for the opportunity. I feel like it's so important to have an idea of where you want to take this, of where you want to take this health-wise, of where you want to take this opportunity-wise. And, or if you start like how I did, I had no idea what I wanted. All I know is that I didn't want to go to a cardiac specialist anymore. And I didn't want to be called a walking heart attack or a ticking time bomb. I didn't want those things. But I also knew that I didn't know what I wanted. I didn't know that I could meet an amazing group of people or have reconnected relationships or have a chance to be a leader and have a chance to be able to grow, you know, in myself and learn all these different things. But with along with all of those things comes fear, comes comparison, comes self-doubt, comes different things that might be stealing our joy. But also what can come is growth, positivity, new relationships, rekindled relationships, healthy lab results, the way that we look at ourselves differently in the mirror, like we love what we see looking back, all these things that can come with this journey of these products that aren't just products, but they're life-changing products. So when I say that, I say that it's important to have these dreams and ambitions. It's really important, but it's also important to put those into perspective. And it's important to put those into perspective when it comes to the products, how we talk about it not being a quick fix. Hi, Stephanie. I can't hear you guys, by the way. Can't even hear my voice on the other line, but I know that Becca said that you could hear mine. So if you guys have any questions or anything, if you want to throw it out in the chat, something's wrong with my speaker. But sometimes we can lose ourselves in the pursuit of these endeavors that we're going after. And when I say lose yourselves, it's something that I have experienced over the last few months for sure, but more recently last week. We have probably seen, if you guys have taken notice, some people have left the company to go to other new things. Maybe something else is shinier on the other end, or maybe there's more passion on the other end for something, or maybe somebody just didn't have that belief or found another thing that they were excited about. Whatever that is, it's always important to cheer those people on. It's always important to, you know, be that cheerleader regardless of where somebody goes. The fact that they were in this same journey where you find yourself, even just for a minute, makes it all worthwhile. And sometimes that can make us reevaluate what we're doing. Sometimes it can cause and create questions of, what am I doing here? Or am I still really excited about this? Or does this still really make me happy? Or am I really being consistent with the products that I'm taking or the water that I'm supposed to be drinking? Whatever that is, these things can start questioning. It can take one person, one customer to stop, one person on your team to leave. And it can really come up and take all this work that you have been doing self-development. I mean, I've read almost every John Maxwell book possible, and I've been reading Rachel Hollis, and I feel so strong. And then all of a sudden I am just like smack dab on the ground, right back to where I felt like I was 5 years ago. And I didn't know why. I don't know why that can happen, especially when you're like preaching like positivity, or, you know, have that mindset. All you need to do is be positive. Like, it's one thing to say it, and it's another thing to actually feel it. But what really smacked me in my face last week was, and when I really realized how far back I had taken myself in here, was one of our team members, beautiful girl, love her, Laura Watley, has found an opportunity with another company. And I am so happy for her. And she was very admittingly saying, I just don't feel like I have passion with health and wellness supplements. Like, I just am not passionate about health and wellness. And I mean, to each their own. I think that it's wonderful if you find something that you're passionate about. But what really smacked me upside the face, like front and center, was my response to her telling me all these things of how great our team has been for her and how amazing and how much she's grown and all of these things. The first thing that came to my mind and that I actually typed out was, could I have done something better? Could I have done something different? And what happened in my mind was that I was taking her saying that this wasn't a passion of hers and putting the blame on me, like making it seem like it was my fault that she wasn't interested in health and wellness, or making it feel like it was something that I did or something that I could have done differently to make her passionate. And so that was a really eye-opening moment for me, because I feel like you can find yourself along these paths of almost when you're saying that you're not trying to, like, you have so much belief, or even if you've lost that belief or taken a step back from that belief, you cannot physically put that, you can share your belief and you can share your hope, and you can take everything that you want it so much for that other person. And like, even if you see it in that other person and see and feel like that they have what it takes, if they don't feel that, if they don't reciprocate that and really, really believe that and open themselves up to that belief, then you're going to be spinning on this hamster wheel. And there's a thing to be said about not having belief when you first start, because we don't know what we don't know. And belief grows stronger. Belief goes stronger with your own testimonial, with your own story. Belief goes stronger when people join you. Belief grows when people trust you. But what I've been really kind of reflecting on over the last, let's just face it, many months recently, is that you can do everything in your power to try to want and feel as hard as you can down to the depths of your soul to want those people to come with you, to want your best friend to come with you, to want those people on the team want it as much as you do. And at the end of the day, all it's going to leave you is exhausted and self-doubt. It can even strip you of your own belief. And that's a real, truly big thing that can be, I don't know, blinding in this industry or in this company or in this journey. When you have someone that you think is so capable or so special to you that you don't want to go one more day without them on this with you, and they say no, or they end up phasing out, or they leave to do something else, that can really mess with you in here, because you're thinking, well, if this person doesn't believe it, why do I believe it? Or, well, what's the point? Like, why am I going to try so hard? Because that nothing's going to work. Nothing's going to, you know, follow me. So I'm exhausted. So why put that energy into people that don't want it? And then you start that vicious circle of lies of, no one wants to hear what I have to say. No one wants to read my posts. No one's liking anything. And it's always that, it's that negative and that negative and that negative, to where you can really find yourself down at the rock bottom. And it's a hard place to be, especially when you feel like you've been doing the things and doing the work and working through. But I think that a lot of us maybe tend to work through the surface perimeter of what we need to work on or what we might be scared of. And we're not actually working through it. We're working around it to try to get to the other end, but we can't get there because we have some roadblocks. So we actually have to work through. And working through is hard. And working through is going to slap you and knock you down. And you have to get back up again and dust yourself off. But it's a really pivotal, eye-opening moment. And one that was completely vulnerable for me, because after I typed that out, like, what could I have done differently to have you stay? Sitting there, and I was just like, oh my gosh, like, I am exactly in the place where I try to tell people not to go and not to be, and all of a sudden you find yourself there and you had absolutely no idea that maybe that you were there. So I think that a lesson for me is that I know that, like, I feel like there's a lot of different opportunities, maybe, you know, that piques different interests. For me, I know 100%, 110% from everything, I mean, swear on the Bible, that I know that I will never find something that will change my life as much as Plexus has changed my life, as far as another opportunity. Like, I love that people can go and find something like makeup or leggings or anything like that and be super passionate about it. Because I think that there are, like, people are super passionate about fashion, super passionate about skincare, and super passionate about different things. For me personally, I know that I am not going to ever stop. And so it's been a really big lesson, as far as, at some point, you will either achieve what you're going after or it will end. And that's where it is. And it's not even like a middle area. You will either achieve what you're dreaming about or what you're going after, or it's going to stop, or you're going to let it stop. And either way, it doesn't define you. It just is a matter of fact. You are going to keep pushing and keep going and keep, but doing it in a pace that's comfortable for you, or that makes you feel true to what you're doing. I think that there's quite a few people that started this journey and might feel like they weren't doing it in the way that made them feel good about themselves, or they weren't doing it in a way that made them feel like that they felt natural about it. If it's unnatural for you, if there's a different thing about being scared versus being feeling like unnatural. Like, I literally, like, if somebody says I am not a people person, you don't want to push that person and be like, you have to be a people person. You've got to talk to people. I mean, that's not going to be their way. It might grow into their way because they might become less introverted, or they might become less fearful of talking to people. But I think that when you find yourself sharing about this opportunity, or trying to find those people that are like-minded like you, that want these same goals and aspirations, or that you can learn from, or different personalities, I think it's just really safe to say that people are going to have it within them, and you have to let go that this is on you. I feel like personally for me, I have carried a lot of responsibility over the last 5 years that I have brought on myself. Responsibility of making sure people feel educated, responsibility of making sure people are guided in the right direction, responsibility of helping people, like, log in, you know, as customers, you know, all this responsibility. And I think when that weight of responsibility is on you, it can stop being fun, and it can stop being purposeful, and it can stop feeling like that you're this, like, the servant leadership. What it starts feeling is that things are chasing you constantly. And that's one of the things why I named this call what I did, because there are things that we can negatively choose that are going to be constantly chasing us on the hamster wheel. People, like, negatively, things like approval. We're constantly maybe having that approval just chase us. Like, why are we so scared of having other approval? Because it's really taking our happiness and putting it in the hands of other people. We have that though. Like, that's a thing that's real and that's legit. And I think it can happen all the time. Like, you may say, okay, well, I don't care what people think about my posts. I'm going to put myself out there. But then it's the approval of maybe a family member, or maybe the approval of your team, or like you're always going for someone's approval, which is kind of going against the grain of what you're really trying to do and set out and be you and be yourself and not worry about anything else. So that's a negative thing that can chase us. Perfection. That's a negative thing that can chase us. People, I hear all the time, well, I don't have the perfect words for that. There are no perfect words. Your words are perfect words. There's no perfection in posts. There's no perfection in outer beauty. So like there's a lot of people that are scared to share pictures of themselves or to share their journey because they don't feel like they're where they're supposed to be yet. There is never going to be a moment where we all feel perfect about ourselves. The perfect situation is having people watch you along your journey and stay with you along that course of the way so that people can have an understanding and a realness and a rawness of that genuine self that you are. But there's never going to be that perfect moment. There's never going to be that perfect picture, those perfect words. So perfection that chases us down is definitely something that can just completely spiral us out of control. Now there's a couple of buckets where I would say these are negatively chasing us and also in a positive way to chase after. So fears, that can be a negative thing that's constantly chasing us, but it can also be a good positive thing that we're chasing. So fears of public speaking, fears of what people will think, fears of social media, fears of not being at the point where we are health-wise. Those are things that can negatively impact, that can just completely keep setting you back and setting you back and setting you back. But if we put those in a positive way and we are chasing those fears, but in a positive manner to where we really want to tackle them rather than running away from them. So that's kind of where I say those completely two separate buckets. Timeline. Having a timeline on this is something that we negatively can have chase us. That is definitely something that I found myself in probably more in the beginning of my journey. Like I always used to be so, I don't know, feeling so disappointed, thinking like, oh my gosh, it's taking me forever. Well, who cares? Like, who am I comparing myself to? Or, you know, what timeline is this realistically setting in my head? If I know that I'm never stopping, and I know that I'm going to achieve someday, someday is better than no day. And, you know, that timeline in my own mind is just constantly putting that expectation of never doing enough because I'm not reaching where I want to go. And that's what's really important about setting those small goals, having that big picture idea, but having those small goals. If we don't have those small goals, that big picture doesn't exist. Because there's absolutely no way we're going to get to that big picture without those stepping stone goals. And if you're constantly having this timeline of, in your mind, of trying to set yourself up for success, and that timeline is negatively chasing you, you're just going to feel like you're failing every day. And that is not true at all. So that's another negative thing that I feel like we let chase us. Also, people. Negative people we let chase us. And I think it can get into your head. It definitely has gotten in mine before and probably more recently. It's interesting how even one person can really just completely come and just almost like shake you up from the inside out. And I have personally experienced that over the last few months, more on a professional level at work, but it was kind of tied in with Plexus as well, to where it almost made me feel ashamed and not purposeful and just really that shameful feeling of you know, questioning myself in my head, like, why am I doing this? Or is it bad that I'm sharing about this? Or is it bad that I'm talking about this? And really just asking those negative questions. And that one person, just one person, whether that's somebody in your life that has nothing to do with your journey, or if that's somebody who trusted you and then left, or somebody that shut their order off and didn't tell you, or somebody that made a comment to you when you walked into a family function, whatever that is, they're going to be there forever. Those types of people who might be jealous or envious or upset that they don't feel like that they have that drive, or they think you're ridiculous because you're dreaming big or you're reading a self-development book or whatever, those people are always going to be there. We can't outrun those people. We can't run faster than they can. And they're always going to be chasing us. But it's the way that we deal with and handle ourselves in that situation. Because we can get down on their dirty level. We can. And it's very easy to. And it's very easy to come back in a defensive mode. And it's very easy to let them, I don't want to say win, but let them win in here. It's super simple to let that happen. And it happens really fast. And it happens sometimes without our control when we even realize that it's happening to us. But it does happen. So those negative people that are chasing you, rather than trying to outrun them, put your arm out. Let them link arms with you and see if they can change their mindset and turn into someone that they actually enjoy being themselves. Because when somebody is negative like that in your life, or negative and are tactful in a manner, going after something that has nothing to do with them and has everything to do with yourself, that's on them. That's something, that's an issue that they have with themselves. That's not an issue that they have with you. Even though it really feels like it, that's an issue that they have with themselves. And it can negatively impact you in such a harmful way to where it does maybe take you down to rock bottom. And I say that in a completely vulnerable state because it's happened to me over the last few months. And it's really eye-opening to where you feel like you've been working on yourself so much. And you get to a point where you're like, oh my gosh, where did that work go? Like, where did that work go? And it's hard for you to put yourself in a position where you don't feel worthy or valued to pour yourself into other people, to share about what you love, to have that belief of what it is. And it's just kind of makes you question everything over and over. And I say that with a grain of salt because I'm there, I've been there, I'm currently there, and it's a hard place to dig yourself out of. But I promise you, you grab that shovel and you keep throwing that, slinging that mud to the side, and you're gonna see that light, and you're gonna get yourself back up to where you were, and then you're gonna learn from that negative experience or those negative people or those negative things being said, and you're gonna be better for it. And it's not about killing that with kindness, it's really about putting those blinders on, but also not letting someone dull your sparkle or burn your light out. Like, don't let anybody do that to you, because that is what those negative people are going to do for their entire life to other people, because their light's out. Don't let them put your light out. Their light's out. They're trying to do that to everybody around them. And if you can take a step aside and just pause and realize that, and realize that, again, this is not on you, this is on them, it will kind of make it, put it in a different perspective, because it's really easy to get on that level. Another thing that can be negative, where we find ourselves that's maybe chasing us, is success, but that's also in a bucket of the positive. We can be scared of success, but we can be scared of success in a way for like berating ourselves for not obtaining it. That's a big thing. I think that when you are going after something, going after a rank or going after, you know, just anything on your journey, whatever that success looks like for you, because it's going to look different for everyone, it becomes our own version. And sometimes our own version of success is something that we're, again, telling ourselves a lie about. I know for me, like the last, every time I go into a license bureau, I'm like, okay, I'm going to get 1 year tags. I'm going to get 1 year license plates. Cause next year I'm going to have that Lexus. I'm going to have it. Like that's my, you know, that's big picture. And what happens is, okay, so this year, when I went back in, all I could think of in my mind was, man, like I was just here last year and I promised myself that I was gonna earn that car and I was gonna have those things and be on the way really closer to more of the financial freedom to change my family's life and all of those things. And what's happening in my mind is that I'm taking all of that hard work and all of that self-growth and all of that self-development, and I'm not enjoying the journey. I am looking at a thing that is leveling my success, that's determining my success, and I'm taking that success and I'm pushing it all the way down because I haven't gotten the car. Like that's not something that is okay. And I am so quick to recognize those things now, and it takes the enjoyment out of the journey. And I want that back in for you. And if it's still there, congratulations, it's awesome. But I will tell you, it will be that roller coaster. And if you're finding yourself in that downslope, I know that there are a lot of feelings of maybe frustration or things are going slow or, you know, people aren't ordering as much or whatever that is. I go back to when I was at a convention in one of the breakout meetings, and I cannot remember for the life of me which ambassador said this, but she said something like, I hear people all the time complaining about, you know, I only got this much money, or I wanted the planner, but I only got a water bottle, or I only got, and it's more just talking about like the financial goals. And she said, I have to stop and say, like, not you only, you take that only word out, and you're, I don't care if it's $7, I don't care if it's $50, I don't care if it's $2,000, you are making a paycheck. And it's up to you to want that paycheck to grow. And it's up to you to do that work to have that paycheck grow. You know, like they talk about how we can't expect to go to a job, a 40-hour a week job, let's say we're on commission and sitting there at our desk and expect to be paid. We just can't expect that. We can't have those expectations. So if you are doing this for that extra income, if you are doing this for that compensation, if you're doing this for that goal of what you have, of that bill, that next bill or that next mortgage or whatever that may be, then see what you can do to get to work and see what you can do to self-evaluate what you haven't been doing versus what you have. And that will really put the puzzle pieces together, because we can lay it out and say, okay, what have I been doing? We can look at those IPA sheets over and over and over, and not focus on what we haven't been doing or what we have not been doing, and just have it be more of a big picture and really just putting the action items into play. I think that we make this a little bit more difficult or a little bit more complicated than what it really can be. And at the end of the day, it's a relationship business. It's a people, person to person business, a relationship business. And we get so caught up on people not liking our posts or people saying something or people not, you know, we get so caught up on those little things that don't matter that it stifles us to stop doing the things that do matter. And that is building relationships, making connections, putting this into the hands of people who need it. We have to forget about the small things that don't matter at the end of the day, that whoever didn't respond to your message or whoever read your message and didn't write back or whoever got a sample in the mail and didn't drink it. We can't control those things. I know they're frustrating. I know they are, because I'm firsthand you send a sample to someone and you're like, oh my gosh, how could you not just rip that open as soon as you've got it and not pour it in water and like drink it now? Like, you need this. We can't control those things as much as we want to. What we can control is our mindset, is our actions, is our ability to put ourselves out there in a genuine way, to talk to people, to watch a training video, to be passionate, to put our words into action. Those are things that we can control. Those are things that are probably the first to go off of a list once we feel like we can't do this, or once we feel like we're not good enough, or once we feel like we are shaming ourselves for wasting our time into something that's clearly not working, right? How many people have said that before? I think that we find ourselves in that mindset and it's really paralyzing. So I wanted to talk really quickly. I want to see what time it is. It's 8:37. I'm sorry. I'm going over. I wanted just to really focus and tell you guys that many of us chase after what seems possible, instead of what we're really capable of doing, because we limit our aspirations. They are too limited. We are limiting them. And so we always seem to chase the impossible. But I want you to take a look at the list of possible things that are out there for you. And that is our own story. Don't forget what your story is about. Don't forget why you started. Don't forget that very first person that joined your team that made you so excited. Don't forget about the positivity that comes along with all of this, about the group of people that we are here with that are going to cheer you on. Regardless if you use Plexus as a stepping stone to a new venture, or if you are in this for the long haul. I know that Karen Ritchie, she, our lovely Canadian, she's awesome. She found herself in a new venture. But I will tell you that she sent me a message and she said that she was so thankful for finding something to give her the confidence that she needed to pedestal, to push her to where she wants to go in the future with her own idea and her own visionary of health and wellness, that she is going to be doing a speaking engagement in front of like 50 people. And she said, without the confidence that our team had given her, without the leadership that we've given her, that we've offered her, she would have never been able to take herself and put herself in that position. And like, to read that and to know that she, like, this is what Plexus gave her and this is what we gave her, regardless if she never shares another day about this, like, that makes me happy. That makes me feel fulfilled. So if you're using this as a pivotal moment to find your path, more power to you. I think it's amazing. But if you want to take this for the long haul, then let's do it. Like, let's go together. Because I know that there are a lot of people out there that want what is at the end of this big, like, shiny tunnel. And at the end, it still doesn't stop, because you keep going and you keep sharing and you keep, going after what you want. And whatever way it is that people find their path to give them the life that they want, to give them the happiness that they want, I just am thankful that we can all be a part of it together. There have been people that come and go. There have been people that leave and never come back. There are people that leave and come back because that they realize that that green grass they thought was so much greener isn't. That comp plan that they thought was so amazing, it's not. Or that new product out there, that new something shiny that they thought was so enriching and it was going to like give them that fulfillment that they were lacking, it didn't. So it's maybe not the fulfillment that they were lacking with the Plexus products. Maybe it was the fulfillment they were lacking within themselves. So, but whatever that is. And then there's some people that go on and leave and become so successful and so amazing. And whatever that is, wherever this takes you, like, I applaud you. And I applaud you for being here. I applaud you for starting. I applaud you for growing. And I applaud you to keep going after what it is that you're going after. But to have these opportunities that are kind of all surrounding us, with people going in different parts or people sticking to one thing and really focusing on it and growing with it. Whatever that is, make sure you're not living for accomplishment to accomplishment. It's not about accomplishment to accomplishment at all. In other words, like, be mission focused instead of position focused. And that is really all about it. Like, don't be so focused on your rank. Don't be so focused on people who aren't following you anymore or people who aren't saying stuff anymore. Don't be so focused on that. Be focused on what your mission is. Be focused on what you can control. Be focused on where your blinders keep you. And I say that because I have found myself at that bottom again, and I will never, ever go back to that place again. Like, I won't, because I've been in there way too long for the last couple of months. And I think that it's even gotten me to a point of where I don't even feel sometimes worthy to, like, go live on our team page. And that's ridiculous, because that is something that I love doing. And it's something that I won't let the opinion of one person or the outcome of something, I'm not going to let that knock me down anymore. But I just wanted to say, like, do what you can now, focus on what you can now, embrace your current situation, and don't get so fixated on what we can't control, because I think that that's really going to take the joy out of it. That's going to take the happiness out of it. I think that if you make that decision, whether or not you know what that decision might be, but if you make that decision to get out of bed every day and just become a better you for that day, plexus or not plexus, whatever that means, if you make that decision, I think that that's going to bring you the things that you might be lacking, bring you the things that might be stealing that joy from you, bring you the things that might be taking that smile away or that peppiness away that used to have that spirit in you, and bring that back. It's going to change everything for you if you allow it to change. But I think that this is bigger than your plexus journey. I think this is bigger than, there's a reason why we are all here. There's a reason why we all have found ourselves here, whether that was we were looking for positive affirmations, whether we were looking for outside approval, whether we weren't happy with ourselves, whether we weren't happy with the way we looked, whether we weren't happy, with the way that we feel, whatever that is, we're here. It has brought us here, and it's up to you on where you take that, not anybody else. It's not up to anyone else. And if you take that weight off of your shoulders, it's going to make this ride, although bumpy, it's going to make it a fun one that you want to be on and that you want others to join you. Because I will tell you, if you are not having fun with this, this is a chore, if this feels like something I have to rather than I get to, then maybe this isn't the place for you, or maybe this isn't the right time for you to share. Maybe you need to take a pause and to grow and to develop a little bit more and to build your belief back up. But it's a really pivotal moment for you when you get to say, I get to do this. I get to be a part of this company. I get to be a part of these awesome products. I get to be a part of this rocket ship. I get to be a part of this legacy, rather than feeling like I have to do this or else no one's going to come to me. It's not that. Let people chase you in a positive way, and knowing that you have gold in your hands, rather than you chasing everyone else, because we don't want to convince people. We want to connect with people. And that is where I will end this. I know it's 8:45. I've been talking my head off, but I had a lot to get out today, tonight. And I don't know if this relates to any of you guys or where you're at. But I've noticed a trend, and I've noticed a change, and I've noticed that it's been negatively impacting me. And I don't know if you guys have felt the same way, but, I see some chats. I know that my speaker is not working, and I'm so sorry. I can't hear your voices. Yes, Becca, regroup and get together. Like, I want nothing more than to have everyone get what they want out of this experience and out of this journey. And I was going to say that you can go after these big goals, like at convention, like my gigantic goal. And I was so excited to hit that $2,000 check, and it's $2,000. Like that's a thing that I will never forget. But I also remember feeling how I was feeling, like up on the stage, I was feeling, I thought I was going to have this like, oh my gosh, this is the best moment of my life. This is crazy. And what I felt up there was something completely foreign and something completely different than what I was feeling. All I felt up there was that I was up there alone, and I wanted my team to be up there, or I wanted to be back sitting where my team was. Because to do that, like I was only up there because of my team, and to not have my team experiencing that same thing and being up there with me, it's not worth it. Like it's not what you experience or what you imagine it would be. And I think that you don't do this alone at all. And you can't, because you will burn yourself out. You will be exhausted. So there's an important factor in having those side cheerleaders and having those people support you and having that validation, and having that support of where we feel like we truly are in something special and unique. And it's still, I have friends that I talk to that are in other multi-level marketing companies, and the environment and atmosphere, no matter the roller coaster, is never, ever one that what we have. And that is where I feel special. And that is what I can say that makes us stand apart more than anything else. And why I will always stick to this. And even though those shiny things or those new opportunities, or you read about new things coming out, like I get why people jump. It can be exciting. It can be refreshing, re-energizing, something new. But at the end of the day, that lull or that downslope is going to happen no matter where you are. And if you keep jumping and jumping and jumping and jumping, you're never going to be satisfied. You're never going to feel fulfilled. And you're never going to feel like you are worthy or entitled to something. But finding what you are good at, finding what you're passionate about, and really sticking to it, there's something to be said about that. And I think that takes a lot of notice by yourself personally and by other people. So thank you guys for listening this evening. I know I can't hear you and I'm sad, but if you guys have any questions, feel free to type them out. And I am going to be putting this up on the team page, and I'm going to be doing, I just feel like there's a lot of important messages in here and a lot of different things that people might be able to pull from. So I'm going to be giving away a free bag of Slim to people who listen to this and give their biggest takeaways. So you guys, for being on the call tonight, get 2 entries for a free bag of Slim by being on. So thank you for listening. I love you guys. And I hope you guys have a good, oh, little sweet buddy. Look at his face. He's so cute. I can't hear you, Becca, but is he always that smiley? Look at him. That just makes it all worthwhile. Thank you guys for listening. I love you guys. I hope you have a great rest of your Sunday. Bye.